Welcome back to Ottolini Cuisine. This is where Ottolini goes on vacation to Jamaica. Now, if anybody knows about my past at all, I spent almost 2 years down in the Caribbean sailing boats and delivering boats between Florida and Venezuela, and spent a lot of time down in the British Virgin Islands and in and out of Jamaica. One of the greatest food items out of the Caribbean and most famous is the jerk. The jerk has an amazing history. It's a jerk comes from some old French words, they think, but it kind of meant to dry and to preserve. And it's like what they did with the jerky. They'd hang out beef, they'd put so much pepper, so many things on it that it would dry out and it would preserve it. So now they have this jerk sauce that they marinate their meats in, chicken, pork, fish, and it is a fiery, spicy spice. You saw earlier during the prep of the different things we use, the habanero or scotch bonnet that they use down there is the main one. So what we're doing today is we're doing jerk chicken two ways. I've got one spatchcock, which you've seen before when I've basically butterflied a chicken, where you take the backbone out and get it nice and flattened out, and you get all the stuffing in, or all the flavorings inside underneath that skin. Don't get rid of your skin on a chicken. That is the savior of what hides the spices underneath and then holds it all in and then gets crispy. If you want to get rid of it afterwards, God bless you, throw it away. But don't take it away while you're cooking it, because that little bit of fat, that little bit of power that it steams underneath is beautiful. So we've done that, and we're doing a beer can chicken, which I've also jerked, stuck with lemon, stuck with thyme, stuck on top of a beer, and we're going to put that in the barbecue. And then we're also going to roast an eggplant out there, and we'll be making some rice later. But just to get started with a little bit of this Jamaican night, here we go. So here we've got an eggplant that we're actually going to roast. I've got the oven at about 400 degrees. We're going to slide this guy. This guy has been marinating for about 6-7 hours. And with all, well, you know what, you don't really need to do that. That's, well, you know what, we're going to. Why not? We've got habanero. Cook them. Cook them if you got them. So this guy is going to slide in the rack at almost 400 degrees, and she's going to be in there for about 45 minutes. But now, come with me, because we don't have one kitchen. We've got at least two, and we're going to introduce you to our second kitchen. Out here on the side patio is kind of our bar and kitchen unit, where I've got a flat-top grill, I've got a bar, and I've got a barbecue, one that burns coal, one that burns gas. Tonight, we're burning coal. I've got the coal fire going strong. I've got the beer can chicken stuffed with a beer and a lemon up inside and a bunch of thyme, and I found this really cool little stand. You can do this with just a beer can, and the legs will actually keep it from falling over. But if you've got one of these, it's that much easier. So this guy just literally slides right over here, like so. And then we're gonna slide these cabbage, which I've done with kind of a dry, limey jerk sauce on the cabbages. We're gonna allow them to roast along with this chicken. And you notice I got it off the heat. So you get your fire over here, your chicken and your stuff over here. We shut that off. It's indirect heat on this beer can jerk chicken. It's gonna be unbelievable. You'll see this rice I'm making later, which is also pretty crazy. But here we go. So, kada boom, all done. Open up that vent, let her smoke, and here we go. Now, the other thing about the Caribbean, I spent a lot of time in the British Virgin Islands. I used to run charters down there. I spent almost a year doing sailing charters down there. Over here in the west coast of California, we've got Catalina Island. Famous drink, the buffalo milk. Quite a sweetheart of a drink, but it's vodka-based. An island drink should be rum-based. And one of the greatest of all time island drinks has to be the painkiller. The painkiller, I've made many. I've drank even more. And it's a genuine sweetheart. So these cups are actually from the BVI. They're the tin cups. Normally, you're going to use pussers. I don't have pussers. I don't need pussers. I don't necessarily really like, well, I can't say that. In a painkiller, pussers is pretty good. But pussers is a high alcohol wine, or high alcohol rum. And so What's the next best thing to Buster's, or maybe even a little bit better? The old Sailor Jerry. Sailor Jerry's is a high-octane rum. You get a little bit in there. You get a little bit in there. And then here's the painkiller. So, what you're going to do is, it's basically two-thirds pineapple, one-third orange juice. Here we've got some pineapple juice. We go one, and two, and three, and four. That'll make us about two, so it's about 2 to 4, actually. So here we go. One, and two, and whoop, there we go. And then the ultimate secret, Coco Lopez. Not coconut water, not coconut milk, but cream of coconut. This is the baby. Coco Lopez is the classic. This is the new boy in the block. We get a little bit. It's kind of one part to everything else of the coconut. Bing. We got a little bit of ice in there. I'm gonna shake this up. I'm gonna get that coconut mixed up. The coconut's really thick. Boom. Oh, look at the creaminess of that thing. These are ridiculous. These are one of the greatest drinks of all time. It brings me back to the Caribbean. You're listening to a little Bob Marley. Life is beautiful. But one of the keys, another sad, sad moment is I don't have my nutmeg grater with my fresh nutmeg. But come on, you're not always going to have that. And remember what I tell you, you don't always have the perfect tools to make a perfect drink or a perfect meal. But here, boom, 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 boom. And you've got yourself the ultimate painkiller. Now, the Caribbean stir stick. I had one left. Well, I had three left. I got five left of Caribbean. I got 10. You get that nice.
Don't do it tonight.
You want to come home? To the Caribbean? We'll be back with you in a little bit once we start pulling these chickens out of their ovens and out of their barbecues and show you that special rice we got coming. So, cheers, Bob Marley, reggae music, Jamaica, jerk chicken, and the painkiller. Ciao for now. And in this spot, no one can mend it. Cause if them mend it, you can easily bend it. So we are both education. Should be, should be. It's time for one of the chicks to come out of the oven. So, the painkillers are still flowing. This baby is ready. Come on. Come on out. Oh my God. Normally they cook these things over a burning hunks of wood to get this char on here. But look at this. Look at the tenderness. It just wants to... These are these little burnt up habaneros. Look at the other side, little pumpkins. Unbelievable. Listen, get the phone or get the camera in here real tight and listen to this. See if we can hear this. Oh. Can you hear that? That's going to be an eggplant of a lifetime. And over here is this crazy rice. So it doesn't look so crazy, does it? But that is rice pilaf done in a clam juice with clams and coconut and some of the ginger and garlic from the jerk spice. That's gonna be a crazy rice. Beautiful. And this chicken is like, look at, oops. Is it, it just wants to come apart. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, she's happy. Next chicken in just a minute. All right, chickens are out of the oven. Chicken is out of the barbecue. Cabbage is out of the, look at this stuff. This is just like jelly. And look at this eggplant. This eggplant is just going to peel apart. And then we're going to scoop that out, mix it with lime and a little bit of the sauce. here. It's crazy. But so anyway, here comes the chicken. So let's see if we can, too hot? Yeah, it's pretty hot. So remember when you were learning how to have the kind of army lift somebody? You get your arms underneath the shoulders. Oh, there they go, underneath the shoulders. Voila. You know, one of the reasons we've been listening to a lot of Bob Marley tonight was I had the opportunity when I was in Tortola running some charter boats out of there. Bob Marley actually had a studio in Tortola in Roadtown. And we somehow hooked up with somebody somewhere and got into the studio and sat down behind the glass and watched Bob Marley cut the song Calle Now. And hence, ever since then, I've been a big Bob Marley fan. Before that, even more so now because I got the opportunity here. But anyway, I digress. The food. Concept is this. We're going to pull this eggplant. Look at this stuff. This is crazy. This just scoops out. This has been roasted for an hour on a barbecue. Probably could have done a few of them if you were feeding a large family. But we're going for the flavors of the melanzane. Then we mix with a little bit of this jerk sauce here. We don't need much of it because it's pretty spicy. And we don't want to change the flavor of the eggplant too much, but we want to give it a little bit of this love. And then a little squeeze of lime, a little squeeze of lime over this baby. This is island time. It's liming. We're liming. You know, liming is kind of a partying in Jamaica, so it's all right if we're liming tonight. I'm just going to get a little boop, 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 boop. I mean, this is crazy. We got chicken two ways, jerk chicken two ways, habaneros cooked on the top. This baby, boom, and look at that. Oh, let's see how this guy is looking. Voila, chicken, eggplant, tender cabbage, and seafood rice pilaf, clam juice, clams, and Jamaican spices. Our tribute to my beautiful second home, actually I call it my third home, the Caribbean, Long Beach, Venezia, the BVI and the whole Caribbean. Ciao for now. Grazie, arrivederci.